Hello guys, welcome to this new 8086 microprocessor video. Okay, in this video we are going to see how to convert a hexadecimal number into equivalent decimal number. Okay, before going to the program, I want to tell you this: any language, whether it's an assembly or C language or any programming language, you cannot just look into some video and understand it completely. Okay, if you understand, you must write the code, okay, and debug it each and every step, how it works. You have to write the code by yourself, try it out, and then you will understand what is going on. You must get some errors, then only you will understand what is going on in the code. Okay, so before going to the code, this is the code which I have written already. Okay, before going to this code, I'll tell you how this code is written, because there are some steps you must understand before going to understand this code. Okay, see, any books which you read, they may give different idea of how to convert a hexadecimal number to decimal number. There may be a different algorithm, but here when we write the code, it is a bit different than that of doing manually. Okay, because here whatever the operations are done in microprocessor, all are done by by taking hexadecimal numbers only. Okay, so we must understand how to do this, okay, in microprocessor language or assembly language. First step, divide the 16-bit data by 0AH. Okay, see, we are taking a 16-bit data, that means a 4-digit hexadecimal number. Okay, 4-digit hexadecimal number, not 2-digit hexadecimal number. We can take 2-digit also. 2-digit, if we take, it is an 8-bit data. And 8-bit data, for 8-bit data, the steps are same, but some of the steps may be little different. You may have to modify a little different. Okay, you may have to modify. I'll tell you what are the modifications here only. I won't tell you in the code, but I'll tell you how what are the modifications here. Okay, first you need to divide the 16-bit data of hexadecimal data by 0AH. Okay, you know why 0AH? Because decimal number ends at 09. Okay, and this is the comparison of whether it is greater than 9 or not. So we are dividing this hexadecimal number by 0AH. Okay, and you will get two things. One is remainder, and the other one is quotient. Where will be remainder stored, and where will be quotient stored is the question. Okay, in 16-bit division, as we know, remainder will be stored in DX register and quotient will be stored in AX register. If you do the code for 8-bit division, that means if you want to convert an 8-bit hexadecimal number, a 2-digit hexadecimal number into a decimal equivalent, then what you have to do is 8-bit division you have to do. Okay, when you do 8-bit division, what happens? The result will be stored, the quotient will be stored in AL register and the remainder will be stored in AH register. Remember this, not DX will not be used for 8-bit division, but here it is the 16-bit division. That's why we are using both DX and AX. This is by default, you cannot change this. This will be stored in DX, the quotient will be stored in AX register, and the remainder will be stored in DX register. We need to account for both these, okay? We need to use both this in this algorithm. Once we are done, this remainder will give us the first digit of our number, okay? The lowest order digit of our decimal number it will give. So store this remainder, okay? Store this remainder in some memory location. And then what you have to do is check whether the quotient is less than 0AH or not, okay? If it is less than 0H, there is no point of dividing it by 10 again, 0AH again. If it is less than, if yes, store the value of the remainder. This also gives us the last digit of our number, okay, of our decimal number. So if yes, store the value of remainder in the last memory location. Okay, we have to increment the memory location. Whenever we are done with this storing first remainder, we have to increment the pointing register in the language. I will tell you how it is done there. Okay, we have to increment the pointing register to go to the next memory location, again store the next remainder and again go to the next memory location. So at the end, the register pointing at the last memory location will store this quotient. Okay, finally, okay, that will give us the largest digit of our decimal equivalent. If the quotient is not less than 0AH, again divided by 16-bit, again this is nothing but continuous division of your hexadecimal number until your number, I mean the quotient, becomes less than 10, less than 0AH. This is the algorithm. Okay, you understand the algorithm. I assume that you understood the algorithm. This is nothing but just divide the number, which is hexadecimal number, by 0AH continuously until your quotient becomes less than 0AH. Okay, and store all the remainders in your division. Okay, all the remainders one by one, and all those remainders one by one will give you the higher order digits of your decimal number. Okay, we will move to the code here. See, first of all, we didn't write code segment or something before the data segment before this code segment, right? Why we didn't do that? Because we are not dealing with any arrays, okay, or any strings particularly. All the things which we are doing here can be done by a single, the 8086 microprocessor registers only. Okay, it can be done, but still we are accessing the memory locations. If you can see here, we are accessing the data segment also. Okay, but we are not initializing data segment, or we are not creating a segment in our code as data segment, because I told we are not using any arrays. If you don't use any array in your code, entire code, you need not to write data segment actually. Okay, so this is why we didn't write data segment. Okay, directly we went into code segment. I have explained you all these in my previous video. You can see that video about palindrome. Okay, all these preliminary stuff, and I'll directly go to this code, this algorithm based code. Okay, first we are moving this 0FFEFH into this AX register. This is the value, this you can change. Okay, this is the value which I want to convert it into decimal number, this 0FFEFH. Why I have put 0 here is because if I remove this 0, this FFEFH, this, even though it is a legal hexadecimal number, this microprocessor won't be able to recognize it as a number or a hexadecimal number. That's why we put 0. If we put 0, it will come to know that it is a number. Okay, that's why. And there is no change of information, I mean the value of this, if I put 0 in front of it, right? That's why we are putting 0, so that the computer can understand, or the assembler can understand, whether the number, whether what he is giving is as a number or a variable or something like that. Okay, move AX, first we are transferring the value which we have to convert it into decimal into the AX register. Then we are storing, see, this is nothing but we are storing this AX register value, this AX register value, into this memory location pointed out by SI, which is nothing but 1000H. Why we are doing this is because just to make sure that it is not lost, or finally we will know that it is 0FFEFH, it will be in the program. You can see this value. Finally, when we are done with this operation, the value in AX will not be AX only, what we initialized before. That's why we are simply storing. You need not to do these two instructions in this code, if you can remember this value. Okay. So, why this word PTR? Some of you may get confused. This word PTR, this is nothing but word pointer of SI is given. Okay. Why this is came? This came. Okay. Usually we use, actually without these, we usually we always used to do this, right? Just SI comma the memory location SI comma AX. Why we wrote word PTR and SI, or this thing SIX, right? This is done because, you see, this is a 16 bit register AX, so it has 16 bit value. Okay, and this is also a 16 bit register. Is there any problem? Yes, there is a problem. Even though it is a 16 bit register, the memory location, there are two braces, if you can see these square brackets. Okay, these square bracket indicates this is a memory location, isn't it? The memory location accessed by SI is of 8 bit. So if you don't write this word PTR, that's nothing but a word, it says a word pointer. If you don't write this word pointer, what happens is it tries to copy 16 bit data into 8 bit memory location. Is that possible? It is possible, but it will give you a warning that check whether these two have same, the operands have same size. Okay, and it will truncate your value. That should not happen for us. That's why we are converting it into a word pointer in the sense, actually it will point to one memory location first. That means it copies the AL value, the lower half of the value, lower byte, into SI, which is nothing but what value it is, location it is pointing out. For the time being, it is 1000H. It is pointing at 1000H. So AL value will be copied into 1000H and AH value will be copied into 1001H, okay, which is nothing but the next memory location. That's how the word pointer is acting. Okay, the second step is this thing. This you need not to do. I again repeat, this you need not to do, because if you can remember this value. Okay, move SI comma 2000H and this word PTR again 000H. This is nothing but initialization. Finally, we want to store the values, I mean the converted decimal values, into this location. Which location? This 2000H. Finally, your decimal result will be stored in 2000H. Okay, move word PTR, this is the same thing, 000H. I am doing this 000H is done because there should not be any garbage values in that place. Okay, that's why we are initializing. Okay, so you are clear with these two steps. Okay, this first step is not necessary, and this second step is just to initialize the location where we are storing the result. Okay, that's it. And the third step is just moving 0AH into this CX register. I told you why we are doing this in the algorithm. We are just storing this. Finally, we have to divide it by 0AH, right? That's why we go into this loop. Okay, this loop is written, I told you, this loop is written to convert that hexadecimal number into decimal number. First of all, we transfer 00H into DX each and every time when we repeat this loop. The DX register value should be initialized to 0, because each and every time when we divide, see here, divide CX is done. When we say divide CX, what will be divided? AX divided by CX will be done, right? The value which is stored in AX is our real hexadecimal value. That divided by CX will be done. Since it is a 16 bit division, it's remainder will be stored into DX register. Okay, DX register. So what happens is DX register will be updated after every operation, every division operation. So again, for the next time to account for the next operation, I am initializing it with 00. Okay, so divide CX will be done. So your quotient will be stored in DL register. I have told you how this algorithm works. So DL, the quotient will be stored in the memory location SI, which is nothing but first initially it is pointing at 2000H, as you can see. Okay, it will be pointing at 2000H initially. Then once this quotient, the reminder is stored, then we go to the next memory location, next memory location. Okay, then we compare AX with CX. Again, it's the same thing, whether the quotient is greater or not, that we have to check. That's why jump above or equal is written here. That means if this AX is greater than 0AH, which is the value of CX, if it is greater than CX, then it will jump to this loop. Actually, it is not a loop. You remember this. This is just a small segment of code. It's not like a loop. Okay, you may get confused because the CX is used. This value of CX will not change in this entire operation. Okay, value of CX will be 0AH only because I have not written loop up here. The value of CX will not decrement. This is just this is conditional control transfer instruction, which is jump above or equal. It will check this instruction and do this operation. Okay, if it is true, it will do this operation, otherwise it will continue. Okay, since this is not true for the time being, once it is divided, it will be true. Okay, once this value is divided by 10, this value of AX will not be less than this 0AH, so it will again continue, it will jump to up this position, and that will continue again. When it is doing this again, when it comes and executes this instruction again, then this value of DX, the remainder which was stored, that has to be cleared out. That's why again we have written 00H. Okay, that's how it is done. See, it will see whether finally the quotient has reached less than 0AH or not. Okay, till then it will be incrementing SI and it will be storing the values of the remainder into the memory location, and at the end it will be incremented. And at final stage this will be incremented, it will go to the next memory location where no value is stored for the time being, and it will check this. Okay, if it is true, if it is false, then it will go out of the loop. Okay, if it will go out of this jump above or equal, it will go out, and then it will, since this SI is pointing to the new memory location where no remainder is stored, it will store this final value of quotient into this memory location. Since this final value of quotient is less than 0AH, it is also one of the value of our decimal equivalent. Okay, this is how it is done. Let's see whether this code works or not in the DOS emulator. Let's go to the DOS emulator. This is the code I have written. You can see this. Okay, I'll save it and exit. G for execution. See, FFEFH was the value which was actually written by us. If you want to look that value, we have to go to DDS000H because we stored it in this location, correct? Sorry, not this location. We stored it in DDS:1000H, right? FFEF, right? That's where our values are stored. Okay, this is where our values are stored, as you can see in this FFEF. Since this saves it as in opposite direction. AL will be stored here, then AH will be stored here. I have told you how it is stored. FF, EF. Okay. Then, to see our result, we have to go to location 2000H, right? 2000, DTS 2000. This is the equivalent value. This is the final value. See, starting from here, our value will be stored. These are garbage values, okay? These are garbage values. You can make them cleared out, but still, here, starting from here, okay, 65519 is the equivalent of FFEFH, which is nothing but hexadecimal number. You can trace the program, okay? I will show you how to do that. Quit. If you want to clearly understand the program, you must trace it and understand. Okay, when you press debug hex.exe, T you should do. Okay, the first instruction was to store the AX the value, to move the value FFEF to the AX register, which is done here. Okay, if you want to see this instruction, go again and see. The first instruction was to move this FF0FFEF into AX register, which is done in the first trace operation. Next instruction will be showing here. It will move 1000 into SI. Okay, SI is 0000 now. If I do T and enter SI, this SI comma 1000H is done. You see, SI comma 1000H. Okay, then again you do T. Okay, this next instruction, which is SI, the AX into SI will be done, which is nothing but storing the value of AX into SI register will be done here only. If you want to check that whether it is done or not, SI will be pointing to this 1000H as you can see. So you go to 1000H, okay, 1000H. See, you can see that FFEF is stored in the location. This is the way how we can trace the program and understand it properly. Okay, thank you.